guys. So today I want to share another story with you. Today I want to talk about Dorit and PK Kemsley going broke and how I think it's time for you guys to get the hell out of Beverly Hills. No offense. Beverly Hills is reserved for the rich. You could go to North Hollywood. I mean, that's not that far, but you got to get the hell out of Beverly Hills. And then Andy Cohen's baby shower extravaganza. I thought these kind of storylines were like reserved for like Compton or something like that, but not Beverly Hills, but no, the two crooks, or at least that's what Dorit's ex-business partner is calling them, the crooks, are bringing in ghetto storylines. Okay, so what's going on? Now they've been hit with two new judgments on their house, okay? This time it's from the IRS. The first lien is for unpaid taxes back in 2015, totaling $635,000. Like, you guys didn't pay your taxes? What? I mean, what the hell are you guys thinking? You know you're on television. You know you opened that big fancy bathing suit company, and all this time you knew you didn't pay your taxes. Not only once, but twice. So that was 2015. Then they got hit with another lien for 2016 and 14. Oh my God. 2014 and 2016 unpaid taxes, both years totaling $289,000, bringing the grand total to $925,000. That's almost $1 million in back taxes. Now, this is just thuggish behavior. You guys are trying to bring the hood to Beverly Hills. Rumors are people in the hood don't pay their bills, and you guys are acting like you're in the hood. Now, I know you're trying to sell your home, so I'll give you a little credit for that. You are trying to get the hell out of there, but I can't wait. You might need to go get a hotel or something. Get the hell out of Beverly Hills. So let's talk about the problems they're having with selling their home. So we all know these two squatters put their house on the market, and I consider them squatters. You know, if you can't afford it, then, you know, you might be a squatter. They put their house on the market for 12.7. They had to drop it to 10.9. They had to drop it again for 7.9, which is the current listing price. On top of that, he's not even the full owner of the house, which cuts into its profit. I mean, if he gets one, I mean, that's a huge drop in price. And then on top of that, he has two additional liens on the house. Remember that $3.6 million loan that was given to him by the Bellagio Hotel here in Vegas? Well, they've got a lien on his house, and there's another one that the paperwork is starting on for a private collector by the name of Nikos Kyrgios. Okay, and his is for $1.2 million. Do you think they're going to show their dwindling finances on the show? That would be a really, really good storyline now, wouldn't it? Now, even though these two squatters are in major debt, it didn't stop Dorit from showing up at the baby shower. In fact, I don't even think I would have labeled this a baby shower at all. Now, I can't say I blame Dorit for going to the damn baby shower. This baby shower was the nicest thing I ever seen. I mean, it made me doubt my relationship with my mom. I don't think she really loves me. You know, that little cheap baby shower she gave me compared to this one. It was more like a royal ball for Prince Charles. I mean, it was beautiful. All of the heavyweight housewives were there. They labeled it A Star Is Born. I mean, it's almost as good as The Golden Child. Not quite as good, but almost as good. Remember Remy Ma and The Golden Child? Phaedra Parks was there. Oh, I'm telling you people, she'll be back on that show next year. You know who wasn't there? That little hateful, spiteful Kelly Dodd. Rumors are she was on a previous plan vacation, and when she saw all the pictures going on Instagram and things like that of Vicky, Tamara, and Shannon, then she started hate posting. You know, she said some mean things about Vicky having a bad facelift. I mean, don't hate Kelly. I'm sure you could have been there if you wanted to. I mean, right? At the end of the day, though, I think it's really awesome that Andy's having a baby. He really never struck me as the type to have a baby. So it's going to be weird seeing him walking around with little Andy, going around giving interviews to Nickelodeon, stirring up trouble. I bet you he's going to be just like his dad. So that's my Housewives news for you today. In the meantime, what I want to know in the comments section is, who thinks it's time that PK and Dorit stop pretending to be rich? Because I just can't take it anymore. I wonder if I'm the only one. And also, who thinks it's cool that Andy Cohen's having a baby? Also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and that notification button for more stories like these. Until next time, talk to you then. Bye.